With the changing climate and the fact that more than 50% of the US population live within the proximity of the shoreline, I think there is a great need for research and also investment in the field of coastal engineering so that we can be better prepared for future and which are expected to be more intensive storms. We are in the basement of heavy engineering. There is a 85 feet long integrated wave and current flume. The flume enables us to simulate what really happens in the real life at the smaller scale. We can study a variety of problems such as wave interaction with beaches, with buildings, and to use the flume to optimize and understand and better design our building and infrastructure to be more resilient in the face of the changing climate. I think there is a general interest in using more environmentally friendly solutions for coastal protection as opposed to more conventional approach, which requires the use of hard engineering solution for shore protection. So this particular project is trying to optimize the design of oyster reefs to get more energy dissipated and reduced when the wave passes the reef. And that would mean the shore is going to be more protected, there is going to be less erosion, there is going to be less force on the building behind it. We also know that during hurricane, for example, or flooding, buildings collapse and there will be debris carried and transported by wave and current, and they may collide with building and infrastructure, for example, bridge piers or houses. And we study how to model the impact force of waterborne debris on the structures. We also have this instructional small-scale flume. It enables us to show the processes of sediment erosion and movement and beach erosion. And also we use this artificial vegetation to kind of emphasize the role of natural features in reduction and management of erosion on beaches. Most of the research that we are doing are in some way inspired by what we've seen during Hurricane Sandy and similar hurricanes across the country. We need to be more aggressive and more active in terms of coastal engineering research, and we're trying to recruit the best students to produce the next generation of coastal engineers.